The Uskmouth conversion project is really a utopian industrial story. And by that I mean this is taking a coal-fired power station and taking it 100% off coal. But more importantly, it also addresses the material issue of landfill and what to do with non-recyclable plastics. We all know and we're all very aware of the war on plastics. And the reality is that we can no longer export a lot of our non-recyclable plastics. And this facility now provides an opportunity to be able to turn what is a problem into a solution.
2.8 million tonnes of non-reusable plastic is sent to landfill every year in the UK.
We're going to see around about 880,000 tonnes a year of avoided landfill.
I think from an environmental point of view, burning coal was something that the power station started in 1962, and it was the norm then. But now, environmentally, I think it's good that we're moving away from burning fossil fuels to go into a more sustainable fuel.
Fuel pellets will be derived from non-recyclable waste that was destined for landfill.
It's about 50% plastics, non-recyclable plastics, and 50% biogenic content. And by that I mean paper and cardboard, primarily.
From a logistics perspective, we're able to import the fuel via both rail and port, both of which were heavily invested during the coal era, and so that's available to us to now bring in a finished product in order to use as a fuel for the project.
The calorific value of the fuel is 20 megajoules, and that compares with coal at about 25 to 28 megajoules, and biomass, pure biomass, would be around about 17 to 18 megajoules. The calorific value is higher than biomass, which is a benefit to actually the operation of the plant.
There is a safe way to burn plastic, and we are doing that.
This is a world-class project, and the fuel can be used in other coal-fired power stations throughout the world, which is a great business opportunity for Cymec Atlantis and also for the team based here at Uskmouth.
What we are now doing is basically applying 21st century technology in order to apply 21st century emissions control. So one of the major challenges is actually upgrading our abatement systems in order to ensure that we comply with stringent emission level values.
Emission control on the plant is absolutely critical. We will achieve that through tight control of combustion rather than trying to capture or clean the emissions in the flue gases. That's why the quality and the quality control of the pellet is critical to control emissions and not create those emissions in the first place.
SUP will meet or better the stringent emission standards set by the regulator, Natural Resources Wales.
Back in the days of the 1950s and 1960s, when they were designing Uskmouth Power Station and other stations within the CGB fleet, they had the luxury and they over-engineered a lot of the equipment and apparatus, and it was built to last to such an extent that there is still life remaining in a lot of the plants and apparatus that we have on site today.
More and more people are becoming aware of the importance of reuse. The great thing about the SUP conversion is that we can reuse a lot of the existing infrastructure.
It's not an expired asset. It's an asset that has value and can produce electricity again. And you know, there are lots of coal power plants being decommissioned in the UK at the moment. There is certainly a life after coal for those plants.
Yeah. Using the technology we've got here, obviously a few changes, the project is going ahead to burn this fuel, but it's definitely, we will be the future.
Yeah, try and change everything to accommodate the new fuel, better than building new.
So we're anticipating investing more than £150 million in the CapEx side of this particular project. During the construction phase, you'll be talking about many hundreds of workers coming in and deploying that 150 million or more of CapEx that we need to invest in the upgrades.
Uskmouth Power Station has been here since 1962. It's been a big part of the skyline here at Newport, and it's wonderful that he's going to be converted and used, and especially good as it'll supply a lot of well-paid jobs, a lot of engineering jobs, specialist jobs. And it's good, with a decline in some of the industries in South Wales, that this is something that we can be proud of here at Uskmouth.
Atlantis has forged a reputation over the years of being able to deliver difficult projects. MayGen is well documented as the world's flagship tidal power project, effectively allowed us to develop a skills base within our project development and engineering team, second to none in the United Kingdom. What we constantly search for now is portfolio diversification. And to build on all of the unique world firsts that MayGen delivered, we now have an incredible opportunity to deliver another very, very innovative program and project in Uskmouth. It's the same translatable skills. We'll be taking project management, our expertise in grid management, stakeholder management. We're very, very good at government relations. All of these things are now going to culminate in the successful delivery of what is going to be one of Europe's flagship end of waste projects.